The answer is this one, that it's the probability that the message is M star divided by the number of keys. To see why, let's think about our probability space. So we have all the possible messages being ordered. So we have message 0, message 1, all the possible messages. And there's some message that we've selected that's message M star. We don't want to assume that the messages are uniformly distributed. So the probability that the message is M star is not necessarily 1 divided by the number of messages. If the messages were uniformly distributed, then this answer would also be correct. But they're not. We don't want to assume that. Maybe the attacker has some prior knowledge about the distribution of messages. And that's normally the case. Even if we don't know anything about the particular messages, well, maybe we know it's a message in English, and most random strings of text are not messages in English. The other dimension in our probability space is the choice of the key, and there are k possible keys. So what we want to know is, what is the intersection of these two events? So the M star event is this line in our probability space. Each one of these keys maps exactly one message to C. We saw that before, that there's one key that maps each message to C. So we can think of that as being a diagonal line through our probability space. This is the line where the encryption of Ki and Mi is equal to C. Depending on what C is, it might not be a diagonal line. But we can think of it that way, that there's one key that maps each message to each ciphertext. So that means there's exactly one point here where those two intersect. If the distributions were normal, well, that would indeed be the correct answer, that it's one point and our space is size of M times size of K. But the distribution isn't normal. We don't want to make any assumptions about the distribution of M. For the keys, we do want to assume that the distribution is normal, that each key is equally likely. The keys are chosen perfectly at random. So we have the probability of picking M star, and we're multiplying that by the probability of picking this intersecting key, and we'll call that K star. But because the keys are uniformly distributed, we know that this probability is 1 over K, 1 over the size of K. We don't know that about the messages, so we leave that probability as it is. So that's why this is the answer to the probability that the message is M star intersected with the encryption of the message is C. So now let's go back to our definition.